Good morning, and welcome to the Melton Vineyard podcast for Sunday the 19th of April. Whether you're a regular member of Melton Vineyard, a friend, or you've simply stumbled across this podcast, you are most welcome. One of the lovely things that God is doing as we share together in this way is connecting us to lots of amazing people that we wouldn't otherwise have met. And I hope and pray that you'll enjoy spending time with us now. I want to start by inviting God's Spirit to fill each one of us. So let's pray together now. Come, Holy Spirit, we welcome your presence. We thank you that you are always closer to us than the very air we breathe. But in this moment, we want to acknowledge that and stay awake to that reality now. Thank you for your gift of life and the gift of healing and recreation that you give us through the cross of Jesus. Thank you that you are calling us home every day of our lives. We worship you now, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Beautifully made by nature, I've fallen. By grace, I've been raised. You're calling me, I'm coming home. You're calling me, I'm coming home. We are no longer strangers to your arms. No, we are no longer strangers to your arms. 'Cause by your grace you have saved us. So we're no longer strangers. We're no longer strangers to your arms. Exiled by sin, separated by my transgressions, now welcomed in. You're calling me, I'm coming home. Yes, you're calling me, I'm coming home. And we are saved us, so we're no longer strangers. We're no longer strangers to your arms. Father, I'm coming home. Though I have wandered far, your love is reaching out. Strangers to your arms. Yes, Yes, by your grace you have saved us, so we're no longer strangers. We're no longer strangers to your arms.
The theme of this podcast is the beauty of God's creation and his promise of recreation in times of hardship. So Natalie is going to share a little of her experience of this now.
The last few weeks have caused a roller coaster of emotions, haven't they? One of the highs for me has been seeing nature making a comeback. Maybe you've also seen pictures of water running blue again, and clear skies in cities that had been covered in smog. Earth is having a chance to breathe again, and places of decay are being restored. But we're only seeing this beauty through the brokenness of the virus itself, as well as the realisation that we've caused this damage to the earth. I don't know about you, but this has often been my experience in life, that beautiful things can be found in broken places. Last year, my family and I suffered a huge personal loss. I was in agony and couldn't help but question God's purpose and presence in the loss. When I was angry and felt that God had abandoned us, I faced despair. But when I learned that maybe God hadn't abandoned us, that maybe he suffered with us, I was able to move forward. I was able to know his presence even in pain, and to accept his healing and hope for the future. I would never have asked for such a loss, but without it, I might not have known the full depth of his love, as well as his power to renew my life again. As we look at those images of nature in restoration mode, we can look towards the God who created it, and we can hope for more, not just for our own lives, but for the whole world around us.
Thank you.
The very first book of the Bible tells the story of creation. In it, God creates everything. How he does that is a much larger debate, but put simply, a dark, watery chaos turns into a beautiful garden where humans can flourish. The Message translation puts it like this. Earth was a soup of nothingness, a bottomless emptiness. God's spirit brooded like a bird above the watery abyss. God spoke light, and light appeared. If God spoke creation into being, he can and will speak healing into its brokenness. When we see those glimpses of nature flourishing again, it reminds me of this biblical promise that God can and will restore the earth and everything in it. We already have a glimpse of this in the resurrection of Jesus. During the darkest hour, he was raised to life again, bringing new and unexpected hope, a sign of God's plan to speak life into the whole world. Tom Wright puts it like this. In Jesus' resurrection, we don't just see a happy ending to the crucifixion. We see it as nothing less than the launching of the new creation itself. We get to play our part in this. When we start to follow Jesus, we begin to learn in prayer and worship to celebrate his victory in new ways, bringing genuine signs of life, new creation and birth into the present world. Perhaps during this next song, we can think of those known to us who particularly need to experience hope, even in this time of chaos.
You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness. You give hope and you restore every heart that is broken. Sing it to him. Great are you, Lord, 'cause it's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise, we pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise to you only.
You give life, sing it out.
You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness. You give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise, we pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise to you only. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise, we pour out.
Sing to him, church.
And all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Sing it. Great
your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will say, great.
It's your breath in our lungs. That song celebrates beautifully the fact that creation, life, is a precious gift from God. But so too is recreation, the way that God brings healing and restoration both to our lives and to the world. At the start of week 5 of lockdown, it certainly feels like we're in it for the long haul. But when it comes to long-term planning, God definitely has it covered. Nearly 3,000 years ago, through the words of the Old Testament prophet Isaiah, he revealed his ultimate plan for the world. Look, I am creating new heavens and a new earth, and no one will even think about the old ones anymore. Be glad, rejoice forever in my creation. And look, I will create Jerusalem as a place of happiness. Her people will be a source of joy. I will rejoice over Jerusalem and delight in my people, and the sound of weeping and crying will be heard in it no more. No longer will babies die when only a few days old. No longer will adults die before they have lived a full life. No longer will people be considered old at 100. In those days, people will live in the houses they build and eat the fruit of their own vineyards. They will not work in vain, and their children will not be doomed to misfortune. for they are people blessed by the Lord, and their children too will be blessed. I will answer them before they even call to me. While they are still talking about their needs, I will go ahead and answer their prayers. I, the Lord, have spoken. As N.T. Wright pointed out, the resurrection of Jesus was the launching of this new creation, but its fulfillment is still to come. Right now, we are living in the in-between times, experiencing both the pain of brokenness and the first fruits of what is to come.
Natalie has been talking about the four truths contained in the Bible. The world is beautiful, and we all experience that, don't we? The world is broken, and not just the world around us, but people too. We're broken. The third truth is that it can be fixed, the resurrection hope that Natalie was talking about. And lastly, there must be more. Perhaps you instinctively feel this. There must be more. This can't be all there is. When Natalie was talking earlier about meeting God in such a deep way in her own pain and brokenness, you may have been thinking, that's what I need, a God who cares enough to walk through this with me, who understands. Or, as she talked about the resurrection hope of Jesus, you may have thought, I wish I had that. The truth is, we're all broken and we all need fixing. And I have found that when I get to the end of my own resources and stop pretending to myself and everyone around me that I'm fine, that's when I can give God the space to come in and meet me in that place of pain and inadequacy. So if you're there, or if you're concerned for someone else who's in a place of despair or pain, you can lift them up to God. Let's pray. Lord, I come to you in my brokenness. I need your resurrection hope. Just take a quiet moment to lay out before God now your pain or your fear, your anxiety or that person you're concerned about. And we say, come in, Lord Jesus. You who make all things new, please walk through this with me and bring me to life again. Make me a new creation, someone full of peace and grace, so that I can be a blessing to those around me. Amen. Thank you for joining us. If you have something you'd like prayer for, or you have a story to share of how God has used these podcasts, please contact us on prayer@meltonvineyard.org.uk. We very much hope you'll join us again next Sunday.